is, before we go any further, these guys are a full-length documentary in themselves.
Here's a cover.
Count of two, it's guts alone that is keeping Jeff Hardy in action right now. They're a documentary in themselves. I think they're the gutsiest competitors in the wrestling industry today. Their story is phenomenal, and maybe someday you can get the in-depth interview with them, but the Hardy Boys, in my opinion, tremendous future talents, and maybe light heavyweight champions in the future.
I'll tell you what, speaking of light heavyweight champions, Taka Michinoku at D-Generation X in your house crowned the first WWF light heavyweight champion. He defeated Too Sexy Brian Christopher. Christopher in control most of the matchup, but Taka came away with the victory. I know you had the opportunity this past Monday, Jim Cornette, to interview Taka's alleged first challenger.
Well, Michael Cole, I don't know what was going on with that. All they told me was, interview El Unicorn. Time to sit home and think. And they really now are going with the killer instinct that they needed all along to make it.
Here comes the power man of the duo Furnace and LaFon, Doug Furnace. Former, look out! Hardy trying to roll him over. Can he do it?
Yes!
He's almost got him,
Yes, he does! There's one, two, but Doug Furnace kicks out. Furnace, the former star running back at the University of Tennessee, was once a member of an American powerlifting organization. In fact, Jim Cornette, he set two world powerlifting records back in the 1980s.
Well, Michael Cole, at one time, he was thought of as one of the world's strongest men.
Jeff Hardy again after two.